I'm aiming for quite a solid mash at this stage, but I still need a bit of milk, full fat, which I've warmed in the microwave.
Nigella Lawson, welcome back to the project.
Oh, it's lovely to be back.
So good to see your beautiful smiling face and have you back. You, I have to ask, do you have any other names for other kitchen appliances or only the microwave?
I think, no, but I have other words I use. You know how all families speak in the sort of nonsense words. So, you know, I use desecrated coconut and, and when if I get some new appliance, I have to read the instructions. But I can't think of anything in particular. Like if I'm going somewhere, I will have to text someone to say I'm en route. You know. It's ridiculous things. But the real truth is, I actually wasn't aware I said that out loud, you know, because I would say that at home when I did it. It's just a sort of joke. Mispronouncing words. And what's quite interesting is I found out afterwards that all families have those words in a way, or
yes,
they speak, you know, you can end up speaking in a language that, you know, is a bit on the bonkers side. But then, you know, you've got to remember as well, that was filmed, you know, in a brief window in lockdown. So, you know, like, I can't be held accountable for the state of my mind then.
Nigella, you're in Melbourne right now. What brings you to Australia?
Oh, well, I'm here, I'm very glad to say, for the Melbourne Food and Wine Festival. And I just think, like, what a treat, you know, that it's wonderful enough to come here to eat and drink, you know, no hardship. And, you know, something I was just thinking about throughout lockdown, when it looked like we'd never leave our, you know, houses again and never move anywhere. And I kept, you know, keeping in my mind and in my heart the big Australian skies. And then, like, here I am. I feel I have to pinch myself. And, you know, the thing about Melbourne as well is it's a very creative city. And I think that, you know, that the food of every level is so good, you know, that you can get the most incredible snacks, you can do, you can be blown away by, you know, Ben Shuri's, you know, adventurousness in his cooking. And you've got every sort of expression of interest in food, passion for food. And as a food obsessive, it kind of, it feeds my soul as well as... as well as my tummy.
And on Sunday, you'll be hosting a three-course lunch for almost 500 people that you have designed. Will any of it be heated up in the microwave?
I should hope not. Maybe a bit of warm milk here and there. No, but it'd be fun. And I tell you, there's something, you know, that I'm not, it's not my event, but there's something I'm absolutely, like, desperate for. Like, it's got my name written all over it, and that is the Maximum Chips event. Now, chips are food of the gods. I mean, no debate.
Yes.
In their every manifestation. And I think there will be many. So, elasticated only, much puff, because I'm here to eat. So I'm, you know, no body con, no. That would be not in the spirit.
Some people go a kebab after a late night, Nigella. Are you a hot chips lady or a kebab lady?
Well, do you know, I rather like a chip kebab. So one of my favourites is flatbread, hummus, bit of lemon zest, chips, some lemon juice and salt, and wrap up. Now, that is so good. So wonderful.
Yum. I want one now.
I know. Why haven't you got one
Nigella.
Now?
Nigella.
I know.
But, you know, that's, Nigella, what, but my... you know, that's what coming here is like.
She can't hear me.
Yeah, sorry.
Nigella, darling, I was just going to tell you that my cooking skills are somewhat underdeveloped, but I've always been inspired by your baked ham in Coca-Cola. Now, I want to know whether 2 litres of Fanta would have the same effect.
Well, I haven't done that, but I've tried many other drinks. I've done cherry coke. I've done ginger beer, ginger ale. I think you could do Fanta, but I think I'd water it down a bit and add quite a bit of lemon juice or some fresh orange juice as well. That's my view.
Okay. I'm absolutely inspired. Thank you. Idea of baked ham and Coca-Cola.
It's incredible. Although the fact that Fanta had to be watered down, I didn't realise it was the strongest of the soft drinks. This is quite a remarkable record.
Well, it's not it's very intensely orangey. Hmm?
Yeah, well, that is true. Hence the intense orange colour. When I imagine you at home doing a dinner party, I don't know what to imagine. Are you entertaining people, sitting down, having a conversation while the food comes out, or are you running around all over the place, just putting out
dinner parties
and putting the food out like the rest of us?
Dinner parties, I don't think of them as dinner parties. I live too informally for that, but I do. I did have people round for the first time not long ago. So I essentially live in a kitchen because it's open plan. So I like to get enough done before so that I can talk to people when they're there. Although I do, I put every reminders on my phone, so every minute a bell's going off and I'm thinking, like, what am I meant to be doing? So I have to write it down. But I try and do things that don't involve that stressiness and things I'm used to doing. And, do you know, like, it's just so great to have people round a table, isn't it? And I think this is what the Melbourne Food and Wine Festival's about in a way, and that we've missed all that. We've missed that feeling of breaking bread with people. And I think, although I'm not a chef or a restaurateur, what I would say is that the hospitality business has really taken a battering. And so it's good to celebrate that. So, like, when I'm at home and I cook, and the way we all cook, really, I think we want to maximise the time. But that treat of going out when, you know, someone cooks for you, and they wash up. I mean, it is. It's so
here.
You know. So I love cooking, but there is something so inspiring and great about being part of all that. So I think, in the same way as, you know, you're a WA, everyone's a bit bruised and had a difficult time, and so it's so good to celebrate these areas of expertise and inspiration.
Well, Nigella, we could chat to you for hours, but we do have to go. You are in Melbourne for the Food and Wine Festival that kicks off on Friday. Hope you don't have to do the dishes after that 500-person event. All the details are on our website. It's always a pleasure, Nigella. Thank you so much.
Lovely to talk to you all.